We gather today to remember a man of peerless vision who sought to change the world. And change the world he did. Look around. Even now, the British prepare to retreat. Their spirits broken. Their forces splintered. The Patriot leadership shall soon follow. Either into our service or into the ground. And then, my friends, all of this will finally be ours. We have Haytham to thank for this. He and all those others who sacrificed for our cause. But he was not content merely to save the people of America, no. He sought to save those sworn to our destruction. He sought to save the assassins. Aye, it seems a mad thing now. And it cost him his life. The assassins are a cruel and terrible coven. They speak only the language of death. Too late he learned the truth of this. Murdered by his own son. He gave his life as he lived it, in service to a dream we all share. And so we must fight on. We will vanquish our enemies. We will spread our word. And in time, my brothers and sisters, in time, we will have our new world. He sent me away that day at Fort George. He feared for my safety. I should have stayed. He said there was no danger.
He was wrong.
I will kill you, Connor. This I swear. Not here, though. Not today. No. First, I'll destroy all you hold dear. I'll burn that homestead of yours to the ground and roast the severed heads of your precious founding fathers in its flames. And when I've finished with them, all the rest will burn as well. Your merry band of assassins, the human refuse that lives on your land, your village and its people, all of it gone.
You can try, Charles. But as with all your schemes, this too will end in failure.
Get him on his feet. He will wait. He will watch. And then, when he's seen all his life's work brought to ruin, only then will I allow him to die. Take him away.
Not so bold now, are you, boy?
Where is Charles Lee gone?
The harbor. To catch a ferry.
I believe these men meet the requirements.
You believe incorrectly. They're sick and
they
weak.
Will lead me
We're
to
looking
me.
To build an army, not fill an almshouse.
It would take months to get them into fighting shape, but we don't have the time.
No. Please. We'll do anything you want. Anything. Only take us with you.
Quiet, well.
Your merchandise is useless to us.
Perhaps we should discuss this back in my cabin. disappointed.
As you should be. For us to have come all this way for nothing. Tell me now why I shouldn't have you thrown into the sea.
No need to be rash. Only give me a little more time. I'll scour the other ships if I must. I'm certain there are prisoners who will meet your needs.
Very well. You have 2 days.
Thank you.
Present yourself to the Green Dragon Tavern in Boston with the men you've chosen. We shall meet you there along with our master.
something, darling?
No.
Oh, rude.
Can I help you?
You know you can.
Pardon? Oh!
I do not like having my time wasted.
Stop that! Don't make me call the guards!
Make a sound and you die.
What do you want? He's in the harbor, at the Long Pier, most likely. We heard what happened at the parade. Charles got all nervous, said he was leaving the country. I thought he was overreacting. Guess not. No!
Thank you.
Out.
Why do you persist? You put us down, we rise again. You end one plot, we forge another. You try so hard, but it always ends the same. Those who know you think you mad, and this is why. Even those men you sought to save have turned their backs on you. Yet you fight. You resist. Why?
Because no one else will.
Rough night, was it?
He headed inland. Took a ferry up the Charles River.
I will need passage as well.
Of course. Only say the word.
Why would they leave this behind?
long have we waited for you to return? You have done as we asked. You have succeeded.
No, I have failed. My people are gone. Chased out by those who I thought would protect them.
It is a trade, a sacrifice, and not in vain. For you have found it.
This?
Now you must hide it, where none shall think to look. And then in time, what once was shall be again.
I do not understand.
Nor need you. Only do as we ask. Then you may do as you wish.
But what of my people?
You have saved this place, as was your people's purpose, and that matters most.
It is not enough.
It will never be enough. You strive for that which does not exist. Still, you have made a difference, and you will do so again. Remember, you must hide the amulet where none might find it.
I know where the key is.
Then let's go!
Guess this is it.
We're right behind you.
Moment of truth.
Here, at last. You know our story now. Of how we tried. Of how we failed. All our hopes extinguished. Save one. Your touch. A spark. A spark to save the world.
Wait! Do not touch the pedestal.
Minerva?
You! But how? You left! You destroyed the device!
Did you think there was only one?
What the hell is going on here?
You must not free her.
Free her?
Juno dwells within these walls, awaiting release. I will explain. While we worked to save the world, she sought instead to conquer it. She used our machines to set her plans in motion. Divination through numbers. There is a pattern to existence. To comprehend the calculations is to tame time. This was my focus. And so I built the eye to aid us. But she turned it towards her own ends. When we discovered her treachery, we put a stop to it. And then we left. But first we called to you, that you might try again. We thought it would be safe with her gone. Now I see we were deceived. She survived, she endured, and then she began to work. For centuries, Tinny and I walked the world, hoping to rekindle the spark of civilization. We shared what we knew as best we could. We were not the only ones, but for all the power we wrought, still death would claim us. But before it did, I would have one last look to know if we had succeeded.
That's how you're here now?
I had hoped you might find this place. And finish our work. But it is too late. You and the Templars have squabbled over our refuse. You have wasted centuries, and so you have lost your chance. You cannot hope to stop the end now, Desmond. Only to survive.
She's lying! Only touch the pedestal and the world will be saved.
Better the world burn than she be loosed upon it.
Is that so? Show him then.
But he will not understand. It is complicated. It is...
Show me.
If you heed Minerva, the sun will have its way. The ground will crack and spit fire into the skies. All the world will burn. But this does not end the world. Merely heralds its arrival. Darkness follows. Then you emerge, resolving to lay a foundation that such a tragedy does not befall the world again. You will become a symbol to those who survive. Hope, knowledge, determination. You will inspire them to rebuild, to thrive once more. And as the world heals, so too will humanity. But you are just a man, frail and mortal. You pass from the world, leaving behind only a memory. A legacy. You will be remembered first as a hero, later as a legend, and in time, as a god. It is the cruelest fate, to have written words that meant well, and see them made wicked and unwise. What was meant to encourage life, used instead to justify taking it. And so now you see that what was shall be again. So tell me, how is this better? She would sacrifice you, sacrifice the world, for no other reason than to deny me vindication.
They will enslave your kind, Desmond. Is this not why you fight? Is this not why you came here? To ensure more than just your race's future, but its freedom?
What future? What freedom? Billions dead and the whole cycle begun anew? This world has known nothing but heartache and horror since we left it.
Our gift to them, and you'd see it all returned.
Enough!
You must not do this.
Whatever Juno's planning, however terrible it might seem today, we'll find a way to stop it. But the alternative, what you want, there's no hope there.
If you free her, you'll be destroyed.
It will happen in an instant. There will be no pain.
You mustn't.
It's done, Minerva. The decision's made.
Then the consequences of this mistake are yours to live and die with.
You need to go. All of you. Now. Get as far away from here as you can.
Come with us. We'll find another way.
There isn't time.
Son.
You know it's true. It's already started. I need to do this now. So go. Go!
Some sort of global aurora borealis. Never seen anything like this before. Eyewitnesses describe electrical storms and erratic displays of unusual weather. Residents are being asked to remain inside and wait for... Geological surveys are now reporting seismic activity throughout the Ring of Fire. Northeastern Canada is said to be experiencing the largest... On record, satellites and transformers are failing as the flare increases in intensity. Worldwide reports of blackouts and seems to be receding. Residual seismic and volcanic activity is being reported, but nothing approaching earlier levels. Obviously, it'll be a while before experts are able to assess the full extent of the damage caused by today's events. But it appears the worst is behind us. We'll be sure to bring you more as this story develops.
It is done. The world is saved. You played your part well, Desmond. But now... Now it's time that I play mine.
We'll be right back.
you need to help me.
You won't lose your leg, that much I can promise you. But it will hurt some for a time longer. Looks worse than it is. Just keep it clean and you should be fine. Connor, I simply can't get to all these men in reasonable time. I need help. From you, from anyone!
I think I have someone for you. Diana, come with me. I need your help.
Of course. What's the matter?
Dr. White is overwhelmed and needs some extra hands.
I'm no doctor, Connor.
Maybe not. But I have seen you care for people before. You have the way of it.
Diana, perfect. I'm told you have a healer's hand. Please see to this young man. Connor, if you could help the two gentlemen out front.
Thanks, Skip. Good of you to help. I should be all right.
Many thanks, Captain.
That's a spot better, sir. Thanks.
I caught some burn off a rope. It happens. Thanks, Skipper.
Caught a piece of shrapnel in the shoulder. Bad luck. Thank you, Captain.
You did well, Connor. But Diana, you impressed me greatly.
Well, thank you, Doctor. I haven't studied the practice or anything.
Maybe not, but your instincts are superb, and you have a healer's touch. If you had the time, I would be grateful for your help on a more regular basis.
Might be Catherine could watch the young ones a few days a week.
And if she can't, we'll find someone who will.
Thank you.
Old man. Achilles. What is it? Achilles has passed. I'm so sorry. He passed peacefully and with dignity. A service, then? Yes. Please prepare something appropriate. I will see the grave is dug. Can you gather everyone?
Connor, if you are reading this, I have failed to say goodbye as I wanted. But the time never seemed appropriate. I leave this land and all its resources to you. I trust you now know this place has become something of great significance. A community to serve as an example of what this would-be nation could become. But the larger and stronger it grows, the more fragile and difficult to defend it becomes. I hope your friends who are birthing this infant country understand this truth. Your unwavering tenacity and honesty have burdened you with responsibility far greater than any one man should bear. But you, if anyone, are capable. You have given an old man hope that all is not lost. And for that, I thank you. I ask that you lay my bones to rest on the hill overlooking the water. There is no other place on this earth I'd rather be. I am grateful to have met you, knowing you will guide this land and these people to a better future. Yours in brotherhood, Achilles.
Prayer and sermon do not suit this occasion. Achilles was not a man of God. Not my God, at any rate. But he certainly believed in a guiding force. And he is at peace now, and for that we can be grateful. We lay him to rest here, atop the bluff where he made his honorable and dignified life, so he can remain that comforting presence, the old man on the hill, that we have all grown to depend on. You all had your own relationships with him, your own moments, and I implore you to return here when the time is right for you and share those stories with the waves and the trees. Achilles, you will be missed, but never forgotten. Go safely, old man. Safely to where your soul need rest.
I will make you proud, old man. I never properly said goodbye to you. I was not ready. So here I am. The weight of my responsibilities never seems to diminish. There is always something else that needs fighting for. This is something you never warned me of. Maybe because you thought I would have been deterred. You would have been wrong, but I know you were not accustomed to that. Life carries on here. The people seem happy. They are certainly safe. At least for now. One of my brotherhood asked me something I have been struggling with. What happens if, when we win? When we stop the Templars? It is a question I certainly do not know the answer to. Perhaps you did not either. I miss you. As I miss my mother. I hope all is well with you, wherever you are. Goodbye, old man. Until it comes time for me to join you, then I will bother you once again.
Day, Connor. How are you faring?
I will honor him in time. I just hope that what I do is enough.
If anybody is capable of honoring a man the likes of Achilles, it's you, Connor.
How is your church?
It's everything I could have wanted and more. The people here are hardworking and appreciative of my services. They contribute more than most I've seen. I understand our god is not for you. But the community is strong when we gather within these walls. That much you should see.
I will pass through one of these days.
Good day, Connor.
Hello, Dr. White. Diana?
Hello there, Connor.
Diana and I were just having a look over our equipment and facilities. They've seen a great deal of use in the last few days.
So things have turned for the better?
Better than it ever was in Boston. I was missing my apprentice when things first exploded, but now I have Diana. She's better than he was in every respect.
And are you happy, Diana?
I never thought this would be my path, but now that I'm here, I admit it feels right.
One day, Doc, one day, you'll find one, too. She'll come wandering into the village and light up your life. Mark my words, I'm telling you. I have a sense for these things.
Might be, might be. Ahoy, Connor! Look at us! Three bachelors waiting for love, waiting for a drink, whatever comes first. Drink wins!
Women will be lining up for you, Doc. I'm telling you. Ladies love a healer. It's me that's doomed. Who wants to marry a woodworker, eh? Who? Nobody is who.
Hogwash! You brought the folding chair to the Americas. You're a pioneer, an entrepreneur. Women appreciate a man with vision.
What about you, Connor? How is it a man like you has no wife?
I would not be a good husband. I have not the time to give. One day, perhaps.
Yama.
If you're hungry, have extra.
No, thank you. Where is everyone?
Gone west. Been a while since they left. Seems some fella from New York was granted the land by Congress.
What?
Seen it happen more and more. Government says they don't take land that's already owned, but...
How could this have happened?
We're on our own now. No more merry English parts and labor. Which means we gotta go at it ourselves. Gotta pay for it too. Selling land is quick and easy, not quite so nasty as taxes. And since some say they're what started the old war, ain't no rush to bring them back. Clever men, these new leaders of ours. They know not to push it just yet. Too soon for taxes. Too British.
Thank you.
Be safe.
Connor.
Commander.
It's good to see you.
You have what you set out for. What will you do with it?
A fair question. But if truth be told, I do not know. Men with far greater minds than mine will build this country's foundations. A task I am simply not equipped for. Have you played bocce before? I'm really growing quite fond of it. I think I'll have a green belt at Mount Vernon when I return.
All that death and sacrifice, and you mean to leave the important tasks to better men while you play games? I might have expected it.
Connor.
Whether you think you are capable or worthy of the task, after the things you have done to ensure this outcome, you should not have the luxury of peace.
America has no need for
your
services,
gentlemen. Send them back to Britain in a box. Death to the oppressor!
Cut them down!
Yama.
Hey.
advertiser!
Oh,